Welcome. 首先大家，我简要介绍一下那个Nathan Tao 老师吧。哦对，首先是不好意思向大家道歉哈，因为我们的工作的失误，为大家带来了一些不便。然后呢，今天非常有幸可以请到Nathan Tao 教授，来为我们做这次讲座。Nathan Tao 教授呢他是爱尔兰都柏林大学的圣三一学院。汉学教授，还有这个亚洲研究中心的主任，同时呢也是伦敦大学东方和非洲研究学院藏学和历史语言学的教授，曾经在牛津大学、伯克利大学，还有中国人民大学、中央民族大学，进行过访学，然后他是在2009年在哈佛大学获得的藏学博士学位，他呢主要从事的是藏缅语，藏缅还有汉藏历史语言学的研究工作，先后发表过关于古藏语描写、藏语语料库语言学、藏缅语构拟与比较语言学、汉语史市政系统类型学等方面的研究，的论著。他主持过数个欧洲研究委员会、英国艺术与人文研究委员会，还有英国科学院资助的研究项目。他的著作呢，包括藏语、缅语和汉语的历史音系。还有传统语法、藏语动词词根词典，以及与这个Kazushi Iwa 合著的古藏文明文，然后还有他和Lauren 合编的这个藏语市政系统这个集子。然后今天晚上呢，他给我们带来的讲座是关于藏语的被动结构。Okay, so Professor here, I just did a brief introduction of yours, and now you can.Start your lecture.
Thank you, everyone, for coming. And I'd also like to particularly thank Professor Atso for this kind invitation. I've been watching with great interest what you've been doing at Nankai University over these last few years, and am very excited to be able to participate. And then also I'd like to thank Norsang for kindly translating.
欢迎大家来到这次讲座。然后呢，他尤其要感谢阿措老师邀请他来。举办这次讲座，他也在过去的几年关注过我们南开大学，所做的就是我们这个藏语语言学团队所做的工作，然后也要感谢我作为翻译。
Over the last few years, a number of people, and I've been one of them, but not the only one, have been looking at the grammatical relations expressed by ne and tong, and have observed that. The subject of a sentence, broadly speaking, does not switch with ne, but it does switch with tang. Yeah.
在过去的几年，有很多学者做过这个藏语的ba deng和这个 ni na sam ni ni nas nas 的这方面的研究。他本人呢，更是对这个 ni 比较感兴趣，而且主要是因为 ni。在跨小句的这种结构当中呢，它是有一个主语的一致性，就是所有的这些小句会共享一个主语。
So I'll just show a couple examples of this to try and convince you it's true.
And 接下来呢，他会给大家展示几个例子来说明这一点，就是如何在这种跨小句的结构中。就是这个呢，它可以标记这种主语的一致性，就是这几个小句是如何有一个一致的同一个主语的。
And then I'll also just mention all the examples in my paper come from Old Tibetan Rāmāyaṇa from Dunhuang. Yeah.
Okay. 他的这个今天所给的所有的例子呢，都是来自于一本古藏文的古藏语的这个典籍叫Rāmāyaṇa， 然后都是敦煌文献。
Okay, so this one, so Nyerpa Songpe Chi Shing, Chik Ki Juk Mala Chik Juk Ne, Trak La Zekte Song Ne, Puksu Jin Na. So in English, the three monkeys followed the ducks, each one taking hold of the tail of one bird, and with Ne, they ascended the rock, and Ne, they arrived at its extreme end. Where the point is, the subject is the monkeys, and they are the subject.Before and after the first ne, and before and after the second ne. Yeah.
Okay. 那第一个例子呢是这个，是 Nerpa Songpe Chi Shing Chik Mala Chik Jin Ne 这个蓝色对送你，Puspina，然后这句话里面，我们发现呢，就是，它的主语是三只猴子，就是三只猴子，三只猴子，它是在这个内前的动前面的这个动词，然后那后面的那就是这几个所有的这几个小句里面，都是同一个主语，都是这个三只猴子。
Okay, so now, next example. So Prahasti, this is a goddess.
Sorry, Professor. Yeah. I forgot to say the translation of the whole thing. 就是这句话的总体的意思就是这三个猴子呢，虽然这文章里面没有写出来啊，其实应该上下文里面就是这三只猴子，它是跟在就是鸭子的后面呢，就是每个人抓着一。 抓着一只应该是一只鸟的尾巴，然后这个登上了岩石，然后到达了岩石的最末端吧。Okay,
so this one, well, first I'll read it in Tibetan. So this is Prahaste Tone, and then she says stuff, blah 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 blah. Che mpa bordo. So Prahaste became angry, and with ne, she said blah blah blah, and in this way she cursed them. So again, the point is. It's her who becomes angry and her who speaks. No change of subject with the name. Yeah.
Okay. 第二个例子里面呢是这个，他还是得听你，然后这个他那很生气，然后中间有一段话，是那样那样，他们个的你这新南面多呢，面多西皮，皮皮出毛，俺把只有等着啊，西就就这个。 其南其南其南其南这个几六不这几西木巴乌鲁，这就是这两个小句，这两个小句其实第二个句子稍微有点复杂，它是因为有引语啊，说了话，然后又引用了一些其他东西，但实际是，结构还是比较简单的。它的这个这两个有内的小句里面，它们的主语也是一致的，就是都是这个查哈扎哈蒂，前面扎哈蒂。
Okay, now on to the next one. So I again showing the same. No. Actually, wait a second. Yeah. So far the examples have been showing that the subject is the same before and after ne, and this is also what. Increasing research by I don't know Abel Zadoks, Zach Beer, some other people has shown. So this example is different. Yeah.
Okay. 之前的那些例子呢，都是和其他学者有做过研究，主要就是证明只要这个ni它可以这些ni的小句中，这个主语是不变化的，就是这几个连续的这几个小句里面。 都是同一个主语，而但是现在的这个第三个例子里面，是一个反例。Okay,
so I read this one. This is Yang Lankapur Lankapurer Chine China Shultu Gatso Chepo Shiki Kumne, and then in the quotes, Treu Maku Tang Tamsini Zampa Toshi Che. Gyapo Rama ne Patsel Patang. Okay. When they reached to Langapura en route, so on the way, a great sea obstructed them. And King Ramana ordered monkeys, Maku and Damsi build a bridge.
Okay. Langapra，在他们去这个Langapra的路上，或者时候呢，气恼就到的话，赫德扬苏秦波西西给肯尼，然后在这个路上呢，有一片大海阻碍了他们，然后后面是这个叫应该是这个叫我说的话，他说，只要马格等丹斯尼三八托罗，就是这个猴子马格和。 猴子胆子，然后两个赶快修一座桥，然后叫我拉曼呢，挂着巴当，然后他是这样下命令的。Yeah,
so if we look at this, it's very clear. So you have gyatso chepo shigi is with the ergative marker gi. This is the subject of the clause with kum, right?
Yes, okay. 然后在这个第二个小句中，我们看到这个动词是 kum。 坑，然后坑的这个subject这个主语呢是这个江醋，而且因为我们可以看到这个江醋它有一个做个标记，江醋青布西吉坑尼。
So then
that okay.
Yeah, okay. So then but for the next one you have gyapo rama ne also with the subject marker the you know it's not na it's ne. So the one who does the katsel is the gyapo. So it means that the subject before the ne and the subject after the ne they're different, right?
Okay. 然后我们再看这个最后一个这个小句，然后这个小句里面我们发现和之前的那前面两个例子不同点是，就是后面的这个例子，它的主语是它的这两个小句的主语是不一样的，就是前面一个是江措嘛，然后后面的这个小句的主语又是亚物，就是这个发命令的人是亚物，但是上面的那个动词坑的主语又是江措，所以和
briefly put, you know, so we have this example and we have this example that make us think ne means same subject on both sides, but this example shows that it doesn't work. So we have two choices. Either we abandon this theory, okay, it seemed like a good idea, but it's wrong. Or okay. We have to somehow modify the theory in order to account for examples of this kind as well.
Okay, 那么我们现在可以看到，就是之前的那种例子，它就是在这个在内的这小句中主语保持了一致性。我们的理论就是我们之前的那些学者的理论都是就是在内的这小句中主语是一致的，你可以标记这个主语的一致性。但是在这个例子里面，我们可以看到United这些小句中它的这个主语是不一样的。那么我们就有两种选择，第一种选择就是 我们要么就是放弃这一个理论，就是所谓的你可以标记这个主语的一致性这一个理论，要么我们要把这个理论做一些修改，然后让就是把这种反例，就是现在这个例三这种反例也纳入到这个理论当中。So
the kind of goal of this talk is to convince you that we don't have to abandon the theory of a same subject over across ne. And that I have an explanation for examples like this one here. Yeah.
Okay. 那么我这篇文章的主要目的呢，就是要证明我们不需要放弃之前的那个理论，就是所谓的你标记了整个这个小句的主语的一致性。刚才老师什么的，对。 突然有点想不起来。OK，反正老师的目的就是要证明这个小句的你还是标记了小句的主体性，但是他需要对这个理论稍微做一下修改，然后就是把这种例三这种反例也纳入到这个也符合这种理论或者这种模式。OK,
so first, so basically, there are going to be three sections, and I just you need to you know stick with me through the three sections. The first section is examples that are like our first two, which is say when it works with ne. Ne works
okay.
The way we expect, yeah?
那这篇文章的话，它有三个部分。第一个部分中呢，它还是会给我们看一些例子。这些例子呢，还是和我们的例一、例二一样，就是这个在ne的这小句中主语是一致的。Yeah,
and then this, let's say, first section, I will give examples of ne following verba sentiendi, which are verbs of sensation or perception. Yeah.
Okay. 然后在接下来的这个的话，是它会接下来的这一节当中的话，它会. So it's section two or section
two.
Right?
This is the first of these three sections, I think. Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, first. Okay. 那么就是这三个部分嘛。然后第一个部分呢，它会然后再给一些这个你紧跟。 verb就是这个感知动词，跟感知动词在一块的这些例子，而在这些例子中，还是一样的，就是它的主语是保持一致的。
So in this example, we have prahaste tongne laibu namla mepa. So prahaste saw it something and with ne said to the devaputras. So the point is, prahaste saw it, yeah. And then she said something. So it's the same prahasti on both sides of ne, right?
Okay, so the here, professor, so tone is the verb of sentence.
Exactly. Yeah.
Okay, great. 那在这个例四当中呢，我们可以看到，就是有一个tone这个动词。刚才老师不是说嘛，他要给一些呢和这个感知动词在一块的例子，在这个例四的话，就是这样一个例子。我们可以看到这个在这里面，扎哈蒂姆通尼，利文纳姆拉米巴，在这个例子里面。 感知动词就是这个看见，痛，然后在这种例子里面，是主语是一致的，就是前面，扎哈蒂看到了，看到之后，然后对神之子们说，神的孩子们说，他的这个主语是一致的。Okay.
So this is just another example. So we talk it through it. So gyalpo rama ne sene. Tukla kongpa, and here the sene is the verb of perception, right?
Okay,
so King Rama heard it and thought to himself. So it's the same King Rama who hears and who thinks, right?
Okay, yes. 然后例五的话，我们看一下，就是亚布拉曼尼阿赞尼图拉贡巴。在这的话，这边的这个感知动词就是阿赞，就是听到。 然后这两个小句呢，它这个主语也是一致的。它这个句子如果翻译的话，汉语的话就是，国王让曼他听到以后，然后心里想什么什么什么，他的主语也是和上面的那个四是一样的，是一致的。Okay.
And then six, just you know, again another example. This one a little bit longer. So 这有松鸡 马。 Chi gung chinna, nupa ni purte song wa tongne, cha yupa na chu yupar chete. So now, well, let me just talk it through. So when with na, the three monkeys went everywhere and got thirsty, they saw two ducks fly away. Ne, so it's tongne, that's the verb of sentiendi, right? And then they figured that where there was birds, there would be water. And so the point is, it's the same monkeys who do the seeing and who do the figuring. Yeah.
Okay. Very good. Thank you. 例六的话，这个例子我们先来看一下，它是这个森吉马匹的公孙呐，我把你不得送往通你，下有把。 下有班呐，吃有班，是的。在这个例子里面的话，一共是有三个动词。第一个的话是，是的，马匹的公匹，然后第二个是通，第三个动词是是。然后，他们的主语都是这个这个，他的主语是这三个小句的主语之间是没有变化的，所以和之前的。
Okay, let me just check. Okay, yeah, so this is the last example in this section. So here goes. Bali chung me tana daki kyu duche songwar tongne dung du chinte. Yeah, and then it goes on. So when Valin's wife looked on, she saw that, well, it's quite hard to get in English, but she saw that my husband went boom. This is how I translate chute song war, yeah. And she drew near. So actually, I should just tell maybe a little bit of the story. This is I forget, but these two monkeys, no, these two eagles, I think, are fighting with each other. And one of them is Valin, and then she sees that something went wrong with her husband. So, and he falls down, so she goes to take a look. Okay, but anyhow, the point is, she's the one who sees, and then she's the one who draws near. So exactly the same as we've been seeing so far, with ne marking same subject, yeah?
Okay. So Guinbo means like collapsed or
it, or no, it's probably some kind of no, I actually think what it is I think that the che marks a noise. Yeah. So that I think that Yeah, so I mean, you can see that sometimes the text is a little bit hard to understand what's going on, and also that the spelling is sometimes very weird. But this is just normal for old Tibetan, right?
Yeah. Yes.
Okay. So now we move to the second section. I'm trying to sneak up on the exceptional example we saw in the beginning. So in the second section, what we have is an implied verb of perception. I call it omission of the verb asatiendi before ne.
OK，那在这个第三部分中呢，第二种情况就是，在这个小句中这个感知动词会被省略掉，就是会被省略掉，它是不出现在句子当中的，但它还是它表示它这个小句本身还是一个感知被感知到的一个东西，但是这个感知的这个动词是没有的。
Okay, so let's just talk through this example. So we have lungpa chiki dor chinna chap nakpo jik bapne chung kiete tung je gipatang. So when they arrived at the confluence of a valley, a black river fell there. And the younger brother, being thirsty, made as to drink. He sort of tried to drink. He was about to drink. And maybe you can just translate this, and then I'll explain
the grammar. 一个山沟的话，沟的沟口，到这沟口的时候，有一条这个 black river， 有一条黑色的这个黑水落了下来，或者流了下来，然后这个弟弟呢，因为喝了起来。
So if you just look at the words, you see bapne, and then you see kente tongshe gipatang. So it in the first case, it's the river that falls. And in the second case, it's the younger brother who wants to drink. So it's not the same subject, yeah? This is the appearance, yeah?
Okay. 那我们再来看巴黎。巴黎和之前我们谈到那些例子是不同的。它也，我们先来看动词吧。第二个，chap，那后续个verb呢？然后这个verb 这个动词的论源是什么呢？ 是Chadnahu， 它是比如说是个 black river， 黑色的河或者什么，然后后面的这句，兄金顶通西西吉巴的这个金顶通这个动词，通，但是通的这个论源，它又是这个兄就是这个兄弟，弟弟，所以它的这两句里面它的论源是不一样的，就是这个主语是不一致的。
Yeah, but if we think about it for a moment, actually, it's totally clear that what the story means, you know, what the only interpretation possible is that it's as if the verb tong were there. It was as if it were, bap tong ne, yeah? Because we're seeing the story from the perspective of the characters. So they go down the valley and then they see the falling black river, even though it doesn't say see. It's the only way to understand it, right?
，那这个刚才黑老师不是说嘛，这一节的这个是要讲到是就是这个感知动词被省略掉的情况。然后我们再看这个例吧，龙巴西格多尔辛南恰布的霍西格瓦布尼，然后他是黑老师认为呢，在这个恰布的霍西格瓦布尼其实就是他看到的那个东西，他感知到的那个东西。其实这儿的如果如果有一个被省略的动词，应该是什么？通就是看到了。 然后这句话其实就是把人们带入了，就是这个兄弟的视角。然后就是他们来到了这个沟口，然后他们看到了这个一条黑色的河，然后他们口渴了，然后喝了这个水。Yeah,
and we might want to sort of I mean, I don't want to kind of make too formal a theory here, but we might want to distinguish between, let's say, the grammatical subject or the lexical subject on the one hand, in which case the subject of the first clause is the black river, and what it's doing is it's bopping, it's falling, and some kind of, I don't know, we might want to call it like the evidential subject or something like that, which is the, you know, the kind of perspective that the story is keeping track of, and in that case it's the two brothers are the subject and the verb is tong, even though we don't see this verb tong, and the ne is showing that the if you like, the evidential subject is the same across both clauses. So it's not, it looks like an exception, but it's not an exception, right? It's the same subject across the name.
Yeah. 虽然看上去好像是这里面的实际的这个论源或者主语是这个恰琴波，但是实际它是有一个就是有一个隐被隐藏的一个叫什么主语，它的主语实际是和第二句相近不相近点通的这个主语是一样的，他们的主语其实都是这个兄弟俩，就是兄其实第二句的话就是兄恰琴波西。 把通力或者是应该是这样的，就是他把这个叫什么感知动词给省略了，但实际上他们的主语是一致的，它并不是一个例外的现象。
Okay, so now we look at a couple sort of similar examples. Yeah, so I'll just go straight into this one. This one,
okay.
So shlamo kangna dukpa takna shama shama. Celte maki zoshing dukne, and then hanumanta zapzapne tongne chongte. All right, so when Hanuman spied, that means see, yeah, where the queen was, that's now she, the queen, having been put in a castle, yeah, she sat with an army guarding her, and Hanuman approached secretly and jumped in through the window. Okay, now you can just translate this.
Okay, 然后我们来看一下例九，例九是，拉木更难的吧？得呢，在地木基粗生的呢，汉那曼达，加不加不呢？通呢，冲的。然后在这个例子里面的，这个例子的意思就是，他其实。 就是有把那个上下文的话，它其实这个主语是第一个主语是 Hanuman，然后 Hanuman 的话，Hanuman 就是他在找或者在看或者在窥探这个王后的找这个王后的位置。 他在这王后在哪里？然后最后发现这个王后被，然后王后是在关在这个关在这个有军队把守的这个地方，开到只有军队把守的这个城堡里面，然后他那边的，然后他就轻手轻脚，蹑手蹑脚的从这个窗户里面跳了进去。
Yeah, so again, I mean, I hope it doesn't get boring, but if you look at the first clause, the subject is Hanuman, yeah? At the grammar level, the subject of tuck is Hanuman. Now, in the second clause, the subject of du is Sita or Hlamo, yeah? And then in the subject of the, let's say, third and fourth clause or is Hanuman. He's the one who jumps, he's the one who tongs and chongs, yeah?
Okay.
So it looks like it goes Hanuman, Sita, Hanuman. That's what it looks like, yeah.
Okay. Sorry, what was your last sentence?
Yeah, so like if you just look at the grammar, it looks like it switches from the subject being Hanuman to the subject
yes.
being Sita back to the subject being Hanuman, yeah?
OK， 那我们来看一下例句吧。例句，老师，我们光看这个例子的话，就栏目刚才那个吧，到底就是它的这个主语是什么呢？就是这个 spy 或者说侦查或者说这个窥探这个动词的主语是肯定是就上下文里面的这个Hanuman， 然后 Hanuman， 然后完了以后再看这个第二个小句的这个动词是 look。 这个主语老师认为他是那个就是他要找的那个汤姆，就是王后。然后在第三个的话，再看第三句，哈德曼达，江江的，嗯，通灵兄弟。然后第三个又变回到哈德曼达。所以似乎好像他的这个就是这个 subject， 就是这个主语好像是在来回的换。第一个是刚开始是这个哈德曼达，然后又变成了。 又变回了这个王后，然后又回到了这个汉德曼达。But
you know, I think that it's clear that let's say, or I mean, even the grammar makes it clear, or the I don't know, it's totally clear, right? That
yes,
that Hanuman talks, yeah. He looks, he examines, if you like, and then the next part is what he sees, yeah. So. Actually, he's still somehow the subject, and it's as if there was a verb tong, you know, as if it were duk tongne, yeah?
Okay.
So, in fact, Hanuman is the subject throughout the whole thing, and that means that the ne still marks same subject, yeah? And it's actually partly because of the grammar, the na and then the ne, that we know that Hanuman is still somehow the subject in the middle, yeah.
Okay. 那我们看这个例九的话，光看这个例子，表面上它好像似乎都就是刚才我翻译的，就是他们的主语是不一样的。第一个的主语是 Hanumanda， 然后第二个主语又变到这个汤姆，然后第三个又变到 Hanumanda， 他们好像是不一样。但是我们实际看这个第二个小句。 Mokki，从性，那其实这个东西是他感知到的东西，他感知到的东西。而我们可以知道这一点，是因为前面有这个德纳，还有这尼这些词的运用，可以让我们知道。就是第二个这种是，就是把这个感知动词给省略掉的情况。其实第二个的实际的主语还是哈德曼达，其实它是一贯的，就是。 哈德曼达，刚开始就是在找王后嘛，找这个王后的位置，然后完了以后，他又看到这个王后在被军队守卫着，然后待在这个城堡里面，然后他又偷偷的或者悄悄的从窗户跳了进去，所以这三个小句，它实际它的主语还是一致的，虽然表面上看上去，我们会以为第二个第二句的这个主语是。
Okay, so we move along and let me just see. Yeah, so this is the third last example of this section. Okay, so
okay.
I just again jump in. So, Chungju Chinte, Tene, Gyapo Ramane, De Pokpar Gyurne, Mepa, and then Shama Shama. She chio gurne. Oops, I did that part already. So it's a she chio, yeah. So when we're back to Valin and his wife. When Valin's wife drew near, taking another look, looking again, it turned out that he, that's her husband, had been hit by King Rama's arrow. And then she said, yeah, okay, you can translate this part. Yeah.
Okay. 我们来看一下这个历史。历史是中的신디디나여우라마라마니나폭발진니미바즉즉시인초然后这句这个这句的这个意思就是，然后当这个文论的妻子，就是这其实这个也是紧接着上面我们那个应该是立下面那个立妻的立妻里面就是讲的故事，还是是后面的后续。然后他是这个瓦伦巴勒的妻子走近，然后看了一下，然后他的这个然后发现呢他被这个拉曼纳国王的箭射中了，然后他又说什么什么什么。
Okay, so I mean, you know what I'm going to say, basically. But okay, so the subject of the chin is the wife, yeah. The subject of the te is the wife, and then you have the na, yeah. She looks, and then who's the subject of the pokpargyur? It's the husband, yeah. So it because he's the one who's hit by the arrow. So then and then who's the one who speaks at the end? The mepa and the shichio. It's again the wife. So it looks like it switches from the wife to the husband, back to the wife in terms of the subjects, right?
Okay. 那这个历史的话，我们和之前那个例子稍微有点像，还是就是第一个小句里面，中的拼的地呢，这个拼这个动词，这个动词的主语是是这个巴勒琼嘛，就是巴勒的妻子。然后再看第二句，第二句是叫我拉曼尼达普贝尔经理。然后这个句的主语，他又不是，他又不看上去好像又不是这个Valin的老婆妻子了，好像又是这个应该是他的丈夫，因为加布拉拉曼尼达普贝尔被这个加布拉曼的箭射中，他这个主语是又是这个他的丈夫，然后后面米巴什么什么这个主语好像又回到了巴勒的妻子。
But you know, again, if we look at it, the it's clear that the middle part, where it looks like the subject is changing, is in fact still what the wife sees, right? So it says she looks tena, and then she sees this popargyurne as if it were popargyur tongne, and so in fact the wife is the subject across all three parts of this sentence, right? So there's so again. You might, you know, you look at it and think, okay, look, ne is showing a change in subject, but actually ne is showing the fact that there's no change in subject, even though it looks like there's a change in subject, right?
Okay. 然后我们主要是看这个中间的这句话，然后咱们这个表面上我们想看上去的话，好像就是箭矢，然后被箭射中的是他的这个主语，应该是瓦勒的妻子。但实际上呢，是中间的这段话其实是这个瓦勒的妻子感知到的东西，也就是看到的东西。他实际的主语还是这个瓦勒琼嘛，就是这个瓦勒的妻子。那可能这句话可以写成叫我拉曼尼。那普贝这帮通你是可能可以写的，就是他这边有一个感知动词的省略，实际他这个并没有他的那个主语并没有发生变化，只是表面上好像看上去这样，但实际他是一个被感知到的东西，然后被感知动词被省略了，然后所以这个小句里面几个动词的主语都是一致的，都是瓦勒琼嘛，瓦勒的妻子。
Okay, so now we move on to the third section, and I have this sort of introductory slide first, which I'll just read, basically. So typically, more animate beings act on less animate ones, yeah? People kill and eat animals more often than animals eat and kill people. So the grammars of many languages show this asymmetry, yeah? So I propose that in the examples treated in this section, the one that's about to come, the convert ne indexes that a less animate being has acted upon a more animate being. And these are termed in the literature inverse scenarios. And actually, those of you who study Gyarong languages will know that that the marking of inverse scenarios is a big element of the morphology of Gyarong languages. Yeah. So
okay.
I'm just basically the point is I just want to introduce this term inverse. Yeah.
Okay. 这个部分的它就是还有实际写下来的，它就是意思就是通常的情况下的话，我一般都是有一个一般都是更高生命度的东西，然后对一个低生命度的东西，发出动作，或者做一件事情发出动作，然后比如说人杀死或吃掉动物这种情况的话，会比动物杀死或者吃掉人的这种情况要更多一点。 或者更频繁一点，然后许多语言的话，许多语言的语法都会反映这一点，就是这种自然的不对称性。然后，在这一节的这些例子里面呢，就是我的proposal，就是我认为呢，就是这个副动词，nas，它表示的是一个较低生命度的一个个体对一个较高生命度的个体发出动作。 然后，那这种事件的话比较非典型，因为它是低生命度向对这个高生命度的个体发出动作。那这种事件是非典型的，他把它叫做逆向，称为是把这种事件称为是逆向的。然后可能研究加绒语的人会比较熟悉，因为加绒语中有这种逆向结构的这种形态标记。
Okay, so now we look at some examples. So I just look at this example first. So dala yiger jite pangpa jinsang gi chung du ong ne gyalpo rama ne da yinpa ngo she ne. So Rama wrote a letter on an arrow and shot it. It came down at Sugriva's feet, and he, that Sugriva, recognized that it was King Rama's arrow. So you can translate and then I'll explain the grammar.
Okay. Okay, 然后第十例我们可以看一下，第十例是 dala yige jide pangba mzhenzengji mzhenzengji zhongde hongni yao rama rama nai rama ni da yinbar ngu hini. 然后这一句话的意思就是这个上下文里面的这个主语 rama 然后他在箭上写了一封信，然后被射了出去，然后 然后这个信来到了，萨格利亚，就是这个真藏的前面，来到他的跟前，然后就认出了，然后认出了这是这个叫拉玛国王的剑。
Yeah, so if again, you know, if we just look at the words, you know, so what's doing the ong? What's doing the ong is the da. The arrow is the thing that's coming. Yeah, and then who is doing the no she? It's Jinsang. Yeah. So okay. So it looks like the subject switches from being about the arrow to being about Jinsang. Yeah. So it looks like there's a change of subject across the ne. Yeah.
Okay. 第十例的话也是一样的，就是我们看这个动词 on， on 是一个动词，后面的那个 si mosi 就是一个动词。他们两个的论源的话，on 的这个论源的话是，真藏，也就是这个sagriva， on， 不对，这个 on 的是来的这个东西不是 sagriva， 是这个剑。 因为写在箭上写了一封信，然后把这个箭射过来，然后这个箭就到这了。然后他这个 on 的论源应该是箭。然后但后面的那个，这个知道是拉玛的国王的箭，那谁知道了呢？知道的这个人是这个萨格里瓦，是这个真藏。所以在这儿的话，这个主语也是不一致的，就是前面这个only on 的这个主语是 剑，而后面穆希的这个论语或者主语是真藏，也就是 Sagriva.
Yeah, so you tripped up there a little, and it's precisely because your mind was already leaping to the correct analysis, right? So it shows how clever you are, Norsang. Yeah. So is this middle clause really about the arrow? No, it's not really about the arrow. It's really about what's happening to Jinsong, even though he's not the subject, right? So this is an inverse scenario. This arrow, which is an inanimate object, is coming towards him. So usually, usually people do things to inanimate objects, but in this case, an inanimate object is doing something to a person. Okay, Sugriva is actually not a person, but we set that to one side. He's animate in any case, yeah? So this is the inverse scenario. So again, like it's different than than the previous cases, because there's no verb tone missing in a sense. Mm-hmm. But the scenario is such that, sorry, it gives you too much to translate, but hopefully you understand, what I'm saying. The scenario is such that the middle clause is really about Sugriva. So the ne is showing still subject continuity. Yeah. But in the first, before the ne is an inverse scenario. It's like, this is what happens to someone, and then he reacts after the ne,
Okay. Mm-hmm. Okay, 这例十一的情况的话和之前的稍微有点不一样。之前的话是老师认为是有些例子里面它是那个就是感知动词被省略了嘛，但是在这个例十一里面我们的情况稍微有点有点不一样。它是就是老师刚才说的这种逆向结构，所以逆向结构就是一个低生命度的个体下对一个高生命的东西发出一个动作。然后在这儿的话就是这个剑，然后来到了这个桑格里瓦或者这个真桑的前面，所以它是一个逆向的这样一个结构。但是这个叫什么？它的主语，看上去是剑，而后面的那个主语看上去是真桑萨格里瓦。但实际上他们的主语还是一致的。为什么呢？是因为刚才老师提的我有点记不起来了。Sorry, Professor Hill. I forgot like part of what you said.
Yeah, it doesn't matter as long as you get the point across, right? The point is that it looks like there's a change in subject, but I'm arguing that there's not a change in subject because of this inverse scenario, right? Yeah.
Okay, 就是看上去好像这儿有主语的变化，但实际上因为这是一个逆向结构，所以这边实际上是没有那个没有主语的转换的，主语还是一致的。这第二个主语还是这个真藏，其实它实际的主语还是真藏，然后后面的这个句子最后的这个句子，也是真藏，就是这个动词 on 和后面的词系这两个动词的主语是一样的，都是真藏。
So now another example, I just read the example first. So Treyu marung pa shik onso she da dasha griwe ne tu de ne bang le mang mo shik zintu tang na.Okay, so it came to the ears of Dashagriva that an evil monkey had come, and he, Dashagriva, sent many of his subjects to capture, him, the monkey. Yeah. So you can just translate it, and then I'll talk through the grammar. Yeah.
然后我们来看十二例，例十二的话，只有马龙把这个翁素西，达卡这一年的丹尼。蒙利蒙布许跟真的等呢，然后在这个例子的意思就是，达萨格里瓦听到了，然后一只邪恶或者一只泼猴来了，然后他派出了许多臣民去抓他。Okay.
Yeah. Okay. So the I mean, this one's a little bit, this come to the ears is a little bit of a strange way of talking, right? But there you go. So what's the subject of the da? It's the I mean, it's the news, right? The news mm-hmm. comes to his ears. And then the subject of the order, you know, the Zintutang is Dashagriva. So again, it looks like a change of subject. We change from the news to Dashagriva's reaction. Yeah. And then actually I'll just go ahead and say, but it's not, right? It's the same subject. It's something happening to Dashagriva and him reacting. The whole thing is about Dashagriva. Yeah.
Okay, 然后这个后面的这个例子，这个等等等，这个灯，这个灯，这两个动词，这两个动词的话，他们的主语，这个大的这个，那什么大，然后其实是大的这个论源，实际是前面的，就是这个消息，哪个消息呢？就是这个马龙巴西公诉，然后这句话就是这个消息是大的这个主语，但后面的这个灯的主语呢，又是谁派的？是这个达卡扎，达卡扎又是这个，其实是第二个的主语，所以它的主语看上去又是不一样的。 但实际上和前面的理论是一样的，就是它是一个逆向的结构，就是一个没有生命的东西向一个有生命的东西做了一个做出动作，就是在这儿的话，就是这个消息，来到了，或者是来到了这个叫什么达卡扎瓦的耳朵里面，然后后面的话是达卡扎瓦。 派人去抓，去抓他，所以实际上整个句子的都是关于达卡扎瓦，他们的主语是一致的，虽然他们表面上好像看上去不同。Okay.
Okay. So now another one. You'll get bored of these at some point, yeah?
No, no. Very fascinating.
Okay. So this one. Mingpo dasha griwa la solpa and then shem shama rama na le trokpe rikpar dru tapne dasha griwa gate trogo nyamne lumpo marutse la jitar trokpa dripala dripale rather. Okay, so shupanaka, that's the brother of Dashagriva, advised her brother that he ought to steal the queen from King Ramana. And Dashagriva was delighted and thought, I shall steal her. Oh, I actually had more in the Tibetan than I needed. Then he asks his advisor how to steal her, but I we don't need to include that part. You know? Yeah.
Okay.
Okay. So you can translate, yeah.
Okay, 我们看来看历史三是 牛大卡扎拉索巴，然后是拉玛拉玛拉玛那里出比日巴地达尼，大卡扎尔嘎地出古尼姆尼，龙布马日贼拉吉特出巴地巴里，这句话的意思呢是，就是这上下文中的这个其实是这个斯巴纳卡，斯巴纳卡。 就是建议他的哥哥应该从这个拉玛那国那里把这个王后给掳，就是抢过来，然后达萨格里瓦很高兴，然后想的话啊，我应该把他掳走，我应该把他抢走，然后他就问他的大臣，马里西该如何抢。
Yeah, so actually, well, yeah, so now let's just look at the grammar, you know, so so who is it who advises the brother? It's you know, this drotapne, yeah, drotapne. It's surpanaka, yeah? But then who is the one who's happy, who's ga? It's Dashagriva. So it again, it looks like it's a change. It goes from being surpanaka to being Dashagriva, yeah? But actually, it's just about Dashagriva. Yeah, he gets advice. So it's still talking about him somehow. So I'm arguing that this is an inverse situation because something's happening to Dashagriva and then he reacts. And then this ne is showing the continuity of the fact that, you know, even when it says it's about Surpanaka. It's kind of really about Dashagriva. Yeah.
Okay. 然后我们再来看这个这里面的动词。首先，动词是 did， 然后就是这个建议的事实呢是。 Sapranaka 上下文中呢，它是 Sapranaka，然后后面的这个动词 Ga 的动词的论源是这个论源又是Dasagriva，或者说这个Dakajava，又是 Dakajava，所以前后又不一致了，但是黑老师他的观点呢，就是这还是一个就是逆向的结构。
It's that Dashagriva is getting the advice, right? So it's still about him. Yeah, that's the point. Yeah.
Okay. So the whole sentence is about Dashagriva. Sapanaka， 然后后面的主语它又是Dasagriva，虽然他们看上去他们的主语不一样，实际他们的主语还是一样的，因为整个事件是关于 Dasagriva， 而且因为有这个need，所以标记这个need标记的出现就是标记了这个主语的一致性，前后的主语实际是一样的，虽然看上去他们不一致。 是因为对他们还是一个就是逆向的结构，就是一个低生命度的向高。So Professor Hill,
yeah.
To hear what's the so it's also an inverse construction, right?
Okay, so yeah, I mean, it would be better if his sister was an inanimate object, yeah. But I still think it's like an inverse construction, yeah. It's because
okay,
the story is about Dashagriva, right?
Okay. 所以在这我刚才不是黑老师他的那个是就是逆向结构的话是一个低生命度向的对高生命度的一个个体发出动作，但是这儿的话可能稍微有点不一样，但它的理论是一样的，就是所以我刚才也是有点没太明白，但它的理论和之前的也是一样的，就这是一个逆向结构，然后他们实际的主语是一致的，然后这个逆。 还是这个标记了这些小句的主语的一致性。
See, I'm hoping you pay attention, but not too close attention. So you notice, it doesn't actually work my argument here a little bit, yeah. So it just shows you're too clever, yeah. Okay, but since
thanks for a compliment.
Yeah. Okay. So since I read it accidentally included it on the slide, I'll just point out that in this second part you have this nyam ne lompo marutse jitar trokpa jipale, and here this nye works like we expect nye to work, right? Is it Dashagriva before, Dashagriva after? So let's say I only mention this because it happens to be on the slide, but also because I don't want to give the impression that all of these examples that I'm giving are normal. They're not. These are all weird examples. The usual example of ne is like this one, yeah, where it's just totally clear, both sides Dashagriva, yeah.
Okay, 首先还好说的就是这些例子的话，它的这里面的例子，有些例子可能比较奇怪，不是普通的那些例子。然后在这儿的话，这个动词name，这个动词name的主语的话是，我现在都，I'm also a little kind of confused. Confused now. I'm sorry. So
I'm just saying, okay, let's take this part. I don't translate it, but you have trokgo nyamne. So he says, oh, mm-hmm. Let's get her. Yeah. And then lompo marutse la jitar trok jipale.
Oh, so this is a normal example, right?
Normal example. Yeah.
Okay. Now I got it. Oh, yeah. 那我们看，如果只看这个例子的下半段，就是 trokgo nyamne. 先看那个就是大概知道 错过年内龙布马的扎了，这点出发第八里。然后如果我们只看这个例子的后面的这一部分，他的主语是很明显就是一致的，就是达卡之外很高兴，然后他想啊，要我们要抢啊，错过。然后他又向他的这个龙布他的这个大臣咨询，该如何抢这件事情。所以后面的这个他反而是就是一个之前我们谈论的那种比较 比较普通的例子，就是内标记主语的一致性，而且这种的话，例子一般没有什么争议。Okay.
Yeah, I mean, just to sort of I don't know, repeat that slightly. You know, you remember way back at the beginning, I gave two examples, normal examples. This is also a normal example like this, the later part, right? And I'm just saying like, okay, look, if you just read Tibetan text, you know, 95% of the examples of Ni are like this. It's just, you know, he does this, and then he does this, and then he does this. So this paper is really focusing on these really weird examples of Ni, right?
Okay. Yeah. 对，他说呢，就是我们刚才看的这个例十三的后半段，它就是一个比较普通的一个例子，就是整个。 整个这个古藏文的里面的例子，可能 90%、95%的例子都是这种比较普通的例子，就是主语都是一致的，就是有这种内的这种句子里面主语都是一致的，但是他现在他给的这些例子就是主语不一致的，就是刚才比如说例十二、十三这种情况里面，看不到主语的一致性，所以他要做的就是解释为什么这个主语，这些主语为什么会。 会不同，因为之前的理论不是说就是你他标记主语的这些小句之间的主语一致性嘛，所以他会把这些例子拿出来，所以这些例子是比较后面的这几个例子比较特殊一点。Okay.
Okay. So let's keep going, and then we get let me just pick, yeah. Okay. So we're you know hanging there. So this is the complex example of it's long. So you know buckle your seatbelt. Yeah. Okay. Let's do it. Simple. Kun sem shen tam che la sarwa nudrup drupa le tsik la wang wei lamo ni lokpar jinang she gyur ne tu tam she tu ni lokpa. Okay, and then actually you see there's lots of dot dot dots. It's because it's a very complicated example. I tried to make it short, yeah? So I read it. A demon practiced to acquire the power to eat all fellow creatures, but a goddess of speech changed the request into, would you allow me to sleep? And he would sleep all the time. Okay, now you can just
translate. Okay. Yeah. Sigla, 就很多耳朵的这样的一个恶魔，然后他想获得吃掉这个众生的这种能力，然后但是语言女神呢变身到他的舌尖上，把他的这个请求变成了就是能不能让我睡觉，然后他一直就睡去了。Professor Hill, do you want to provide some background? Like because it was a
it's
like
a weird
paper.
Sense, yeah.
Okay.
You can take anything from the paper you want. Yeah. Just
okay. Sure. 这个例子其实它有一个背景，就是他说这个故事里面有一个就这样的情况，就是里面有很多这些恶魔呀、恶鬼，但是他们又受到这个神的眷顾，他们可以从神的那儿得到一些恩惠，然后他们只要提要求的话，然后在这个故事里面有一个就是掌管语言的一个女神，她会就是改变这些恶魔或者恶人的这个请求，让他们就是。 误报他们的请求，所以这样的话就可能，反正有这样，这是一个故事的背景。所以在这个故事里面的话，有这样一个叫多尔的这样一个恶魔，然后他想获得这个吃掉众生的能力，然后他就向一个神请求，请求能不能就是赋予我这种力量或什么。然后这个女神，变身以后跑到他的舌头上，然后让他的这个请求变成了我能不能让我睡觉，然后他就。
Okay. Yeah. So so let's just kind of you know go through it in the way we've been. So who does drup drup pale? It's the demon named Many Ears, right? And then who does gyurne? Well, it's the goddess, yeah. But then who does nilok? It's the demon. So again, it looks like it goes demon, goddess, demon, yeah. But my argument, and then okay, forget about the, you know, the goddess is also animate, so fine, but leave that to one side. It looks like change subject, demon, goddess, demon. But the thing the goddess is doing, she's doing to the demon. So the demon is still somehow the subject. The whole thing is about the demon. So I think that that's what this ne means, right? It means even though it looks like it's about the goddess, it's somehow actually we're still talking about the demon, yeah?
OK,
Okay, so now we move on to this example, which you will remember from the beginning. Yeah, this is our big counterexample. So I go through it. Yeah. So Yul Lanka Purer China Shuto Gyatso Chepo Shiki Kumne Treyu Maku Tang Damsi Ni Sampo Tup Shik Che Gyapo Rama Ne Kyatsel Papang. Oh, I should read the translation, yeah. When they went to Lankapura, they were obstructed en route by a great sea. So King Ramana ordered monkeys, Maru and Damsi, build a bridge. Yeah, so you can just...
Okay. 我们来看例15。其实这个例子我们之前已经出现过在前面。 然后在这的话又再次出现了。我们来先来看一下。 就是耶冷가 바람치나 흔들 잠수 진보시기 큰니 这马格登丹西尼三巴托克西杰乌拉曼尼瓜扎巴登然后这个句话的哦这个其实之前翻译过就是他们去这个兰卡布拉这个时候呢他们在途中被大海阻挡然后兰曼达国王然后命令说啊这两个猴子一个叫马库是应该是他们的名字吧马库和这个丹西然后赶快建一座桥
So if I go actually back to the very beginning, where we look at this, this is it, yeah. You know, I talked you through this, but we have the gyatso chepo shiki, so the gi makes it clear it's a subject.
Mm-hmm.
Then we have the ne, and then we have gyalpo rama ne, where the ne makes it clear it's a subject. So it really couldn't be clearer. Change of subject. Also, it's directly opposite, right? Like the one who's doing something in the second clause, the gyalpo, is the one who has something done to him in the first clause, yeah? And so in my translation, you see here, I say, en route, a great sea obstructed them, yeah? A great sea obstructed them. And maybe you can translate this part, yeah?
OK， 那刚才老师说呢，我们现在他又回到了之前的那个第三例，其实三例和15例是同一个例子，但是三例里面我们先看的话，就是这个动词是 come， 第一个动词是 come， come ni， 然后面这个 yawuramani ga zar 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 ba zar ba dang zar 这两个动词很明显他们的这个论源是不一样的，就是第一个的话。 是江醋，江醋秦布西基，因为明显是因为你看它还有这个现在有做个标记，后面也一样，拉曼纳，然后那什么你西萨这个有也有做个标记，所以这个就再明显不过了，就是很明显的就是两个主语，但老师他而且我们可以看现在这个下面的这个老师的翻译。 老师的翻译呢，就是when they went to like就是 en route。
En route is just on the way。
On the way 就是在他们的这个路，就是路途中的话，然后一个大海阻挡了他们。他就翻译是就是根据上面那句话直接翻译的，就是大海阻挡了他们。Okay.
Yeah. So I mean, what I'm going to say now, or I mean, maybe it's sort of, I don't know whether this will work in Chinese or not, but I think it does. So here I translate a great sea obstructed them. Yeah. But if I go here, I translate they were obstructed by a great sea. And I think this passive translation is better. Why? Because the meaning of the ni is that there is no change in subject. So it means that this is a passive construction. Yeah?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And yeah, it works. And it works really well in Chinese too.
Yeah, okay.
Okay. So, 老师的这个，我们先看老师的翻译吧。老师的翻译是，这句话里面，我们看这个后面。When they went to Laka Pura, they were obstructed.The, 英语里面它是老师用了这个被动语态，然后汉语的话，如果翻译的话，也是可以翻译成就是他们被这个大海所阻挡，他认为这样的翻译更好，而且他认为这个是一个被动语态，是因为你它标记的是主语的一致性，所以上面这个例子，讲错情报是给坑的，虽然看上去它是它的失事是这个讲错，但它实际的主语还是这个和后面的是一致的，后面的这个小句就是加乌拉曼呢，所以整个句子这个你标记主语一致性的这个理论还是成立的，然后他认为这是一个就是就是一个被动式。Okay.
Okay, so that's basically it. But I will just summarize the argument very swiftly. So maybe in four parts we go through. First part.Introduction.
老师他说现在这个文章基本就是这样的，然后他现在要回过来，然后我们再做一个总结，就是他讲了四部分嘛，然后他把这四部分再做一个总结。
Okay, so first part, this introduction where we see usually ni means the same subject both times. Yeah.
Oh, sorry.
That's the so I'm summarizing the argument in four steps. Yeah. The first step, introduction.Is on either side of ni is the same subject. Yeah.
Okay. 所以老师现在总结的就是现在是第一个部分，一共是四个部分。第一个部分是这个，就是这个简介部分。第一个简介部分，它就是提到的这些ni的这些例子，它是这些例子里面主语无一例外都是一致的。
But then I gave you this example where it doesn't work. My theory doesn't work. Yeah.
Okay.然后他又给出了这个例子，但这个例子我们很明显就是看到老师的这个理论是不成立的，就所谓这个内标记这个主语的一致性，因为很明显我们刚才已经分析了这个例子，它的主语是不一致的。
So then for the rest of the talk, I sort of slowly snuck up on this example, if you like, yeah, yeah.
So what do you mean by
snuck? It's like I put the.Pieces in place in order to explain it. Yeah.
Okay. Okay. 那其实他的整个文章的目的就是要他的最重要的目的其实就是这个例子。但他接下来要做的就是把每一篇把这个找出这些就是一步一步的把就是来证明他的观点。
So now this is the second part of the argument.Where it's the first step in, you know, if you like sneaking up on that example, where I just show these cases where there's the verb tong or the verb sen. Yeah. So they're totally normal. You know, there's nothing special about them. They just happen to have verbs of perception. Yeah.
然后后面的这些例子其实也是一样，他们主语也是一致的，但是碰巧他们的这个动词。比如说这个例子的话是 jahdin tong 这个词是感知动词，但它基本上都是一样的，就是主语还是一致的。
Okay, and then
感知动词在一块的情况，主语还是一样的。Yes.
And then in the next step, we just notice, well, you know, sometimes it's so clear that it means tong or it means send, it means look, it means see, that they just leave it out. Yeah. Yeah, but then this was the moment where I introduced the idea that we can, because of examples like this, we can have two notions of subject, the direct subject of the verb, and then what I call the, you know, evidential maybe, or perspectival subject, which is the subject that the story is about in this place.
Okay.
Yeah?
理论就是虽然这个句法上的主语我们看到在比如说这个例子的话它是但实际上他觉得还是有一个 evidential subject, right?
Yeah, I don't know, you don't need to bother with this idea, but 但是大家知道就是还有另外一个
evidential subject, that evidential subject 其实就是整个这个事件的最 的那个主角或者最核心的那个东西，在这儿的话是，比如在这个例子的话就是那个兄弟俩，虽然看这个第二句好像是差不多，但它实际因为有ni的存在，ni它是标记主语一致性的，所以它是实际它的主语是一致的。
Yeah, I mean, just to say the reason I call it the evidential subject is because evidentiality is about like how you come to know something, right? So we're seeing,
yes.
This is we're seeing through the perspective of one of the characters, right?
Okay, see. Okay, the evidential, 他用 evidential 的意思 there的话，其实就是实际我们的视角是在这个 character 就是在这个故事的人物里面，所以Chapnabovani 并不是说实际是就是他看到这个河水在流，okay.
So then I pointed to these inverse constructions, which are sort of, the inverse constructions, I don't have a very good way to put it, but they're not so different, right? They're also kind of taking the perspective of one of the characters, yeah? That something happens to the character is a kind of victim, and then they react. And these are the inverse constructions. Here's what, you know, this inverse construction.
Yeah. Okay, reinforce, 在第二个小句的时候，实际这个主语会变成被受影响的一方，被影响的一方. So they are affected, right? So
yeah, exactly. So they're
okay.
They're...
So in the second clause, so they are actually they are the subject, but
I mean, you can even understand them if you want as like an experiencer subject, you know, like me, you know. I mean, there's a whole literature in typological linguistics about experience subjects, which are often in the dative or something like that, right? Like, they're the subject in the sense that they're what the sentence is about, but they're not the grammatical subject of the verb.
Okay.
Yeah.
所以老师的话就是在这儿的话。 虽然这个语法上的主语看上去是，语法上的主语看上去是就是其他的这些东西它是不一致，但实际上它还有一个 evidential subject. Evidential subject 的话是，怎么说呀？我，
I mean, think about it as like it's the perspective, you know, like the story here is taking the perspective of Jinsang, yeah. Yeah.
真桑，对，在这儿的话，故事我们的那个视角其实是真桑的视角。
Yeah, okay. So then this was the inverse construction. And then this passive is just the inverse construction, except that it's a particularly, you know, clear sort of syntactic example because the sea is in the ergative case, you know, because it's the army that's being obstructed. So this, you know, so this passive is just a type of the inverse construction. Yeah.
Okay, so passive is a type of inverse instruction.
Construction. I mean, if you want to go into the definition, right? What's a passive? A passive is a construction that changes a subject into an object, or changes an, it changes the subject into an object. So here the subject is the army, right? Something happens to the army.
Mm-hmm.
They were obstructed, so they are the subject, but they. Oh, no, now I've messed it all up, but I think I said it wrong. A passive, let's just think, you know, I break the jar was broken by me. Yeah, so So the passive takes the object and changes it into a subject. So here the object is the army. The ocean is doing something to the army. Yeah. But the ni treats them like a subject. Right?
Okay.
Because ni says same subject, both sides. So the ni is saying, the ni is what's telling us we're still talking about the army. Okay. Yeah. Okay. So they look like an object, but they are a subject. But okay. This is a kind of like, I don't know, if you want to see it as a passive, you can see it as a passive, but I just want to show it's not that different from these inverse examples.
Okay.
Yeah.
所以老师说什么是那个 passive 呢就是把这个宾语变为主语的话这种结构的话就是那个被动结构在这儿的话我们看到就是杨子琴波西给坑你其实在这儿被阻挡的那个是军队然后 然后ni在这儿就是它这个句法上的主语好像看上去是这个叫做情报但是因为有ni的存在ni它标记的就是主语的一致性它标记的就是整个这个这几个小句的主语其实是一致的所以后面叫做情报去给坑ni这个这句的主语实际还是叫什么还是那个 和还是和后面的这个这句，然后我让你观察不到，这个是一致的。 So I have a question.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So here, so the second clause, so the agent of the second clause is Yangzhou, right?
That's what it looks like. Yeah.
Oh well, I mean like the subject, the or
yeah,
the
yeah, yeah, yeah,
subject.
Fine, fine. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
The evidential subject is what is army or Jabo Ramana?
Well, the thing is, it doesn't really matter because Jabo Rabana is part of the army. He's the leader of the army, right? Yeah.
Okay, that's all. Okay, 因为我在看这个例子的时候说这个坑就是被阻挡的这个是什么呢？是军队，这是军队。但后面的这个例子里面又是 Jabo Ramani， 但因为 Ramani 又是因为是军队的一部分，所以他们的主语还是一致的。
Yeah. So I mean, I don't know. That's kind of it.